click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, I welcome you all to this video. Here we are with the chapter 2 of microwave engineering, where the microwave linear beam tubes we are taking into consideration. Up till now we have gone through the very popular device, that is two cavity klystron, which is popular as amplifier, and for the purpose of having improved gain and the efficiency we have shifted to multi cavity klystron also. For the purpose of generation of microwave we require oscillator, so the two cavity klystron as amplifier, if modified to get oscillator, it has certain limitations. So avoiding the limitations of that device, we have switched to the reflex klystron. That reflex klystron overcomes all those limitations. In the previous two videos we have covered two problems based on it. Let us have the next problem. The problem statement for the reflex klystron is provided to us. It is, a reflex klystron is operated at 5 GHz with an anode voltage of 1000 volts and the cavity gap 2 mm here. Calculate the gap transit angle. So to read the problem statement, first of all we note down the given details. From this particular problem statement, here we have the given data. As the reflex klystron is operated at 5 GHz, the frequency can be denoted small f is equal to 5 GHz. So giga can be represented as 10 to the power 9 in multiplication to this 5. Simply we write hertz after it. So this is the first value to be used here. Next to that, the anode voltage value is given to us. It is 1000 volts here. The anode voltage is always denoted for the reflex klystron by capital V suffix 0 here. So V0 is equal to 1000 volts. It is the second value. Along with this, the dimension of the reflex klystron in terms of the gap spacing, the cavity gap spacing 2 mm is provided. The two grids of the re-entrant cavity used into the reflex klystron. Here we have the separation denoted by small d, and it is 2 mm, hence 2 into 10 to the power minus 3 meters it is. So with these given details, we have to calculate the gap transit angle. For the gap spacing between the grids of the re-entrant cavity, we have to denote the angle by theta suffix g. G is the suffix for the gap spacing here. So in order to obtain the value of gap transit angle, we make the use of formula theta g computed as, here we have omega into d divided by v0, where omega is the angular frequency that we can express in terms of 2 pi f. So we can write 2 pi f into d divided by v0. So as per the problem statement, we have noted the given details. Operating frequency f is noted, that is 5 GHz. So this value is available to us. Pi is the constant here and small d represents the gap spacing, that is 2 mm. So this value is also available. V0 is not available with us. So for determination of theta g, we require first of all the value of V0 here. So let this equation will be equation number 1. We first of all get the value of V0 and substitute here. So V0 is actually the DC electron velocity. Once only the anode potential is applied to the device, the electrons are generated at the cathode end and they travel towards the anode. So the velocity attained by that one can be given in terms of small V0, and the formula to compute it is 0.593 into 10 to the power 6 into, here we have square root of capital V0. So capital V0 is already provided, it is 1000 volts. Hence the next step to compute small V0 will be 0.593 into 10 to the power 6 into the square root of 1000. Now getting the square root here and multiplying it with the remaining terms, you show in this particular step, we obtain the answer as 18.7523 into 10 raised to power 6. So as this is the velocity denoted by small v sub 0, velocity is always measured in terms of meters per second. So I outline this particular intermediate value. So this intermediate value can be substituted into the equation number 1 at this particular place. Now v0 is available. Therefore, the equation number 1 will imply, we write equation 1 implies theta g will be equal to 2 pi f d upon v0 it was, and it will be now 2 pi into 5 gigahertz, 5 into 10 to the power 9 into gap spacing is 2 mm. So 2 into 10 to the power minus 3 for the conversion of milli divided by this value is 18.7523 into 10 to the power 6 meters per second. So we simplify it to the next step, it will be equal to 20 pi divided by 18.7523 here. So finally, we get the value of theta g. Theta g will be equal to 3.3506. As this is the angle, we have measured it in terms of radians. So I put radians as the unit of measurement and outline this answer. So as per the problem number 3, we had to calculate the gap transit angle, and that value has been calculated. By the next lecture, we shall be taking the last problem onto the reflex klystron. So that will be problem number 4, reflex klystron. So I hope the problem practice is definitely benefiting you for the knowledge of microwave engineering. For more information and knowledge of microwave engineering and another subjects, you can subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you.